You there! Where were you on the evening of September 12th, 1915? So no knowledge of a Mr. Fischerchat, an Austrian working on Section 1 of the Welland Ship Canal? An altercation took place between Mr. Fischerchat and another foreigner, believed to have been an Italian, but he escaped before his identity could be confirmed. By the time I arrived at the scene, I found Mr. Fischerchat with a deep gash in his side, some 6 inches long. No, I will see about that. Where were you on the night of January 8th, 1916? No answer, eh? Quiet bunch. Does any of this sound familiar? One man was seriously injured, and 2 others were cut on the head and chest in a general fracas among the foreigners on Section 1 of the Welland Ship Canal during a riotous celebration of the Russian Christmas Day. A number of Austrians from the East Bank had crossed over in an attempt to disrupt the celebrations of the Russians. One man was hit in the head with a broken bottle, his head severely gashed. Another was slashed about the chest and stomach. I tell you, Dr. McComb at the Canal Hospital is quite busy. By the time I arrived, I found that the chief assailant had escaped down the lakeshore, pursued by the main body of celebrants. When I arrived, I found that only those few injured and drunk men left were around to be questioned, and they provided no useful information. But I called License Inspector King to the scene, and it is no surprise to either of us that both parties had been drinking excessively. In fact, 2 bootleggers were arrested in connection with the brawl. These foreigners seem to be laughing at our attempts to control alcohol in this province. You! Aren't you that political organizer who's been causing problems for the mayor? You wouldn't happen to know anything about the missing dynamite, would you? Yes, dynamite! 28 cases, almost 1,400 pounds of dynamite, gone missing from the Dominion government stores near Allenburg. The theft was discovered recently, and it is believed that unemployed Reds in the vicinity performed the crime. Government authorities are now investigating, since it is believed that the dynamite is going to be used by unemployed Reds in the vicinity to try to blow up the canal. Aha! And what about the murder at Port Weller on July 29th, 1919? No one to answer for that either? The foreigners' camp was found alive with booze that night by Sergeant McCarthy and myself. We'd been called to investigate the murder of an old man named Peter Talsba. The foreigners had been indulging in heavy drinking, and a quarrel had resulted, the old man taking part. It seems he was struck over the head with a bottle and suffered other serious injuries as well. A number have been arrested, but we're still looking for 1 or 2 assailants. Inspector King and I also charged one Emma Coif with keeping a disorderly house and with possession of alcohol. Yes, well. And no one plan on leaving the city. I will be visiting each and every one of you to further my investigation.